You're really and have always been a leader in this. With the Trump administration incoming, does it change what you think about the potential or the ceiling for AI is?
I've always been very optimistic about AI, and I think those of us in the field are. I think there's a lot of changes coming for sure with the announcement of a variety of executive orders. But as with any administration change, we're happy to work with the incoming administration and just need the time to work through all the changes that are coming.
Now, you have quite a lot of exciting things at DeepMind. Has anything surprised you about the rollout of Gemini 2.0 so far?
Oh, yeah. 2024 was an exciting year for us. Midway through the year, we introduced a research platform called Project Astra, which started to introduce agentic features and agents of, like, how can we make AI more useful as a universal AI assistant for people in an everyday life. We advanced that in the December timeframe with a flurry of product announcements, including Gemini 2.0, our most powerful AI model to date, being multimodal from the ground up. And that also is like a step further towards agentic features.
So is there a feature actually in Gemini 2.0 that people like more than others? Is it something that you could explain to us, and also how that impacts your thinking for the next time around?
Yeah, well, maybe what I can do is tell you, I just mentioned agentic features, just to tell you a little bit more. Multimodal really means the ability, as humans, we speak, we look at pictures, we hear, and that's what we mean also with multimodal. So the fact that Gemini 2.0 is a continued iteration of providing that type of seamless interaction with AI while still being more grounded in factuality and bringing some of those new features. Now, what we would like to get to is, right now I can do a search and say, okay, I want to plan a trip, or I'm at the point right now in my year where I'm trying to think through summer holidays, how I'm going to keep my kids busy. Agentic features would allow an AI to take action for you, but with your approval. So we now have that in the hands of some of our trusted testers to help us think through the guardrails so that we can build this technology, making it useful while being responsible in how we deploy it.
So is that for the next iteration of Gemini, is that what you lean into?
Yeah, in order to make AI more useful, we need to bring in more things like, how do we think about an AI having more memory so that it can be useful and know the types of things that you like? Or how do we bring in reasoning and concepts and taking actions in a responsible way? So you're going to see more of those types of features come throughout the year.
So this is like a personal assistant that could actually not only help you with research, but execute for you?
Yes, with your approval, correct. Mm.
How far away are we from actually almost everyone having one of these?
I think a lot of this will depend on how the testing goes with different stakeholders and how we think about ensuring that it's responsible and useful. I think different people have different tolerances, so you're already seeing some people build tools to help AI be more valuable in an assistive way every day. But our goal for AI from the very beginning, when DeepMind was founded in 2010, was to, how do we build AI responsibly to benefit humanity? Big part of that is generative AI, but also in our work around AI for science.
So, Lila, if you think of the next 2 years, right, 2-3 years, which could be a big rollout of some of this technology, how should we think about some of the pitfalls, right, some of the regulation or the safeguards that we as users should be thinking about and you as builders are putting in place?
I think one of the important things that we've already seen is it's not always accurate. We know this as builders, and I think having people understand that, so we still have the human in the loop to ensure that, you're doing your own fact-checking, et cetera. We're also thinking about things like local context. How what this means in one country will be very different. The humor is different, the cultural aspects. So how do we work with local ecosystems, local governments, academics, to make sure that the technology is relevant within the local context? I think that's an area of continued focus. This is generally, we think about if we can find ways to demonstrate the world impact, it's also an important part of how we build trust with society. AI is not slowing down, so we need to think about how do we build this in a more collaborative way.
Yes, is the main roadblock going to be trust from the consumers?
Consumers is an important part, as well as how do we ensure that this technology is regulated, but in a right-sized way that allows us to have both the opportunity while mitigating some of the risks.
Lila, I mean, when you go around the Congress Center and actually listen to conversations, a lot of the focus this year is on AI. Will it lead to job losses, or is it just a matter of trying to retrain, and whose job is that?
Yeah, actually, a lot of the conversations I'm having with governments as well and universities are about how do we think about the future of jobs and what skills are important in the future. And I think, you know, in my 30 years in tech, I've seen a lot of evolution in the types of jobs that people have. So I think what's important is how do we think about reskilling and upskilling. I'm really encouraging everyone, like, start experimenting now with AI. It's so important to get familiar with it so that you can become literate, much like we introduced digital literacy skills in the early 2000s, so that people would have more opportunities with that skill set.
Do you think the new administration in the U.S. is thinking about that?
Yeah, I think governments around the world are thinking about this because they're, you know, and we're partnering not only within Google and Google DeepMind, but also the tech community at large of how do we, you know, AI is a technology that is global in nature, and so we have to think about how we work across the world in bringing this so that it is beneficial to folks.